Lembro.
So this Krishna science is a very great science, and Bhagavad Gita explains this Krishna science very nicely, the origin of everything, and we should take advantage of this great book of knowledge, Bhagavad Gita. It is already known in your country, Bhagavad Gita. There are many editions, but unfortunately sometimes Bhagavad Gita is misinterpreted and people are misled to understand the origin. Therefore, we have the opportunity to publish the Bhagavad Gita as it is. We have entrusted the matter to Messrs. Macmillan Company. They are going to publish the book next month. So try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any interpretation. Then you will understand the origin. So the process of understanding Bhagavad Gita is very nicely stated in the Bhagavad Gita itself. And in our disciplic succession, the Sara Goswami, the six Goswamis, of whom I offered a prayer in the beginning, Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujugo Sri Jiva Gopalako. So we are publishing another book, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. So the printing is complete. That book also will come next month. So I shall request some of you to read the teachings to Lord, teaching to Sanatana Goswami. Now, this Sanatana Goswami, he was formerly known as Dabir Khan. He was born in a high aristocratic family, Brahmin family, and he was finance minister in the government of Nawab Hussain Shah, the then Bengal governor of Bengal. It is about 500 years ago that India was governed by the Pathans, Muslims, and in Bengal the governor was known as Nawab Hussain Shah. Under his government, this Dabir Khan was Minister of Finance, and his brother also, Shakar Mallik, he was also a departmental minister. So both the brothers were in very high position. They were great scholar in Sanskrit and Farsi, Urdu. Farsi, Urdu, you know, the language spoken in Arabia, in that part of the world. So they were very good scholar and born in very aristocratic family, and associated with rich men, aristocratic persons, because they are ministers, no ordinary person could mix with them. So that was their position. And when they met Lord Chaitanya, they decided to retire from the service and propagate the movement of Lord Chaitanya, Krishna consciousness. So he resigned from the service. The Nawab was very much sorry. He did not like that he should resign from the service, because the Nawab was so much dependent on his good service, but he decided that I must resign. So somehow or other, he got a read of the service and approached Lord Chaitanya in a very humble way. Now he is presenting himself before Lord Chaitanya that I am very low born, and my association is abominable. And people call me very learned man, and I also accept that I am very learned. But actually, I am not, because I do not know what I am. It is very nice picture, you see. In the Vedas, the injunction is that if anyone wants to understand the transcendental science, he must approach to a bona fide person, a spiritual master, in such humbleness as Sanatana Goswami is approaching. He is born of a very high aristocratic family, but he says that I am born very low. He is very learned man, but he says that people say me learned man, but actually I am not. Just the position. So why he is saying that? That will be explained. Because actual learning means to know oneself. That is real knowledge. This knowledge that I am American, I am Indian, I am born of this family, I am father of this person, husband of that lady, and this and that, so many designations, that is not real knowledge. Real knowledge is to know oneself. That is being taught by Sanatana Goswami. That I do not know what I am. I am simply identifying myself with this body. And that is not real knowledge. He is presenting in that way. Read next.
You have accepted me as your servant, and you have delivered me from the entanglement of material life. Now you can tell me what my duty is in this liberated state of life.
He was minister. Now he thinks that after resigning the service, he is feeling liberated because he hasn't got to obey somebody who is a materialistic person. Therefore he is thinking liberated. And he is asking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whom he has accepted as his master, now you have liberated me, now you can say what is my duty. He says that you have liberated me, now let me know what is my duty. This is very important point. The Mayavadi philosopher, they think that liberation is the ultimate goal. Just like in Buddha philosophy, the Nibbana. Nibbana means annihilation of material existence. Nibbana. They think that as soon as there is annihilation of this material existence, that is the final goal. The Mayavadi philosopher or the impersonalist, they think that not only to get freedom from this material existence, but to remain in spiritual status, jnanam, simply in the knowledge that I am spirit soul, I am merged into the spirit soul. Oh, that is their goal. But here, the Sanatana Goswami, he belongs to the Vaishnava philosophy. He says